Hi everyone, this is Josh's Cindy Lou, aka 20 Twin Mom, back with another 3 for Thursday. This is going to be how to pack your fuel cell to go to the hospital. I'm going to pack this 3 different ways, and we're going to do an unpacking video right now. So this is the first way that I've packed it. This is for your hospital needs inside the restroom after you've had a baby, ladies. And I've had, I have 6 children, 5 I have given birth to during 4 different pregnancies. I have twins, and each one has been completely different pregnancy and a childbirth. So my very first one, nobody told me this stuff, so I'm hoping to be a blessing to you guys without grossing you out as to all the different things that you will need inside the restroom. Sorry, I had to send my 11-year-old son out of the room real quick. So here we go. This is a fuel cell, and it is packed up for the restroom needs. Now, what I've done with my last baby is I took this into the restroom, and I put this part over the toilet paper holder in the hospital, and that way it just hangs there, and it's there whenever I need it. That's not gonna work. Let's do this. Okay. So here we have alcohol swabs. Now, people don't tell you to bring alcohol swabs. You don't even, especially when you have a C-section, you don't understand the amount of tape that they use for certain things. Now, I had already had a C-section. I had already had an apron, so they had to tape tummy back so that they could get to where they needed to get to do another incision. So there is tons of tape residue left all over, so alcohol swabs are a must. You will really appreciate those when you get in the bathroom. You'll be looking around going, wow, what's all this gummy stuff? It's yeah, it needs to come off, so alcohol swabs. Also, to do with the tape and to do with medications that they're going to give you, is sometimes they cause severe itching. I found this when I gave birth with my twins, as I went through, I don't know what they gave me, but I itched so bad, and they told me bring cortisone from home, and I said, well, that's okay. And they said, yeah, we're not going to give it to you here in the hospital. So since then, I've always taken the hydrocortisone with me, and it has just been a blessing, also for itching and for after getting the goopy off with the alcohol wipes. Now, these they give you in the hospital, these are little, I don't know, they're not pads, but they're kind of like a gauze, and you fold them up and you tuck them under your tummy where your incision is, and it will collect any blood or anything that doesn't need to be going all over. So it'll be where your incision is and where your staples or your stitches are, and you will tuck that up, and then you'll do the rest of your restroom needs. So in here we have some facial wipes, because sometimes you get in there and you just feel kind of crazy, so you just want to wipe, you know, your face and your neck down, make yourself feel a little bit more human. These are the Always overnight pads. Ladies, when you go have a baby, the hospital pads that they give you, it's like riding a surfboard. And I'm not joking. It is as big as a boogie board. So please bring these with you. These will make your day so much better. Yeah, it's bad enough, all the things that you go through psychologically and hormonally after having a baby. You don't need to feel like you're wearing a diaper too. So these are a blessing. These are the Always overnights, and they're in the purple. They come in big packages, and I suggest you get 2, because you're gonna want these there, you're gonna want these at home, and they're just gonna be wonderful for you. So I have a whole stack of those. This is something they'll give you at the hospital, but this I keep in here. It's the cleansing bottle, and I thought, well, gee, what is this for? Well, you put warm water in here when you walk into the bathroom, and I always have a little bit of this. You put just a little bit in there, then you put the warm water, and then you seal it up, and then instead of, because after you have a baby or a C-section, you're very tender down there, and you just want to squeeze the water. You do not want to wipe anything if you can help it. So I fully authorize and and I'm just blessing you with information that you have got to get one of these. If they will give you more than one at the hospital, please take them home, because you can keep one in your diaper bag or in your mommy bag next to your, or in your restroom, especially if you have more than one restroom, and then one in your diaper bag for when you're going someplace. Because even, you know, after a baby, my first one, I bled for 5 weeks and 5 days. And I thought, my goodness, how can someone bleed that much and not die? So, you know, it can be done. So let's get that thing rolling. Also, I have in here Clorox wipes, because after you get up from the restroom, you're going to look like, it's going to look like a crime scene in there. At some point, it will look like a crime scene. So this is just to bless yourself and bless whoever's going in next. Even the people who come to the hospital to clean it, you know, be a blessing to them and clean up after yourself as much as you can. Here's some more pads. Also, I have in here, these are a different kind of pad that they give you. Or these are the ones that you can buy these also. And this is for your wound. So you don't have to tape it. You just roll it up and put it in there, and it'll soak up any excess blood or any excess fluids that are coming out. And then wipes. Always wipes. You've got to have your own wipes, because you just don't know. Your hands are going to be a mess. You could make a huge mess. So this is a blessing. So getting all that out of